Simon Rabinovich is the Asia Economics Editor for The Economist. And Simon, you've just wrapped up a full-day workshop on finance disrupted for The Economist. What were the key highlights and takeaways for you?
Thank you very much. Yeah, I mean, I think one of the biggest takeaways was that this idea of finance disrupted, if we talked about it, say, 2 years ago, it was that you had these up-and-coming fintech companies that were going to make life very, very difficult for banks. These days, I think the consensus has really shifted, and it's now this belief that actually the future of banking is really going to be a hybrid future. It's going to be banks partnering with fintech companies, which then raises the big question of who's going to be kind of the stronger partner in the relationship. I think one of the things that came through quite strongly today is that as banks are waking up to the challenge from fintech companies, they're making acquisitions right now, they're investing a lot in technology. Life has gotten a little bit more difficult for a small fintech startup. They can go for a while, but eventually you've got a big bank that is going to be there to acquire their technology. So we will have more of a hybrid future. It probably will be more of a bank-led future. Another interesting question then is, as that begins to happen, you know, what is the future of banking going to look like? And I think one of the strong views of the different panelists and industry leaders today is that we're moving to a future where potentially we'll have very, very powerful platforms cross-border that will bring together lots of people for different banking purposes. You know, it could be that the payments industry as we know it is going to be wiped out, so people will basically have, you know, fee-free credit cards or debit cards, but that will be a way for these financial platforms to acquire customers and then cross-sell to them, whether it's investment, lending portfolios, insurance, etc. So we're moving towards a future of more and more consolidated banking, which then leads to the final point is, for all of this to happen, you have to have regulators allow it to happen or put down the kind of paving blocks for that to happen. And there's still a lot of uncertainty about how regulators are going to react to this. Of course, there's concerns about, you know, national borders, there's concerns about capital adequacy. This is something where banks probably have, again, a bit more of an advantage over fintech firms. They're used to dealing with regulators. But it does mean that this idea of a single platform finance for everybody globally, it's not something that's going to happen overnight. It may never quite happen like that. The pressure is towards that kind of convergence, but regulators will have lots of speed bumps along the way.